What's up,
big
Kyle?
fan. I've been a huge fan of your video game growing up, Mike Tyson's Punch Out. It was so much fun on NES. Did you ever play it, and were you good at Mike Tyson's Punch Out?
No, I suck. I never played. No, listen, Kyle, I never played the game. I suck. I played it recently in Chicago, and I sucked again. Glass Joe killed me. Glass Joe.
Chris.
Periodically, I get by Glass Joe, but not much.
Hey, Chris, you have a bunch of those
yes.
geeks behind you there.
Yeah, look at everybody behind
say
us.
Say hi to Mike Tyson.
Hey, Mike.
Black geeks unite, baby.
Bring that cup, Mike, just like mine.
I know
hey,
you look
Mike,
good, man. I see
Mike
a little still. Even though you're bald, you still got more bald spots on your head, man.
Chris,
Tyson, I got a quick question. We had Stephen Lott on our show. He talked about how great you were in the 80s. He used to sleep on his sofa. He says you were a great kid. Do you remember those days back in the early 80s with the boxing?
Yes, absolutely.
So you really did sleep on his sofa. He said you didn't have any money, and that's how you had to start your career.
Absolutely, but he didn't have no money either until he really got with me. he had more than I did, so one hand washes the other.
He had some great things to say about you, though. He said you were a great kid.
I have nothing but good things to say about him as well.
Hey, Jimmy, you got a question. Go ahead, Jimmy.
Yeah, with the popularity of your show, has there been any talks with anybody about doing like a talk show or anything like that?
There have been many people talking about doing Cyrus and doing XM Radio, and I don't know. I have to talk with my agents and stuff and my wife, but I think that is something that's I'd really be interested in doing. I don't know. I hope maybe if I'm able to be as raw as possible, we could have a midnight show or something, an adult show. I would love to do it, but I have to be uninhibited. I can't
mm-hmm.
be there and just worry about somebody's going to take away my livelihood mm-hmm. if I say something.
And
you know?
By the way, this is online. I mean, you could probably do it on Google, too, because it's the internet, so we're not subject to...
Once you don't tell me not to be careful about saying anything, I realize I can say anything.
Yeah.
But normally when I come on the stage, they say, Mike, you can't say this.
Right. No, this is all very casual.
I won't say nothing.
Well, that's okay.
Wide open here.
Go ahead. Do you have a question?
Hi, Mike.
Look at do it. Hey, anybody?
I just want to
have a
brag. I have
an Asian invasion, guys. Asian invasion. Help me. My wife
I'm
is going to kill me.
I'm opening a can of Korean kimchi.
No, I just
I'm
want to brag
die.
That I
all
beat
right.
my cousin up.
Oh,
yeah. Yes. Okay, Julie. Got your fill. Go ahead.
All right,
you.
Julie. Julie got the sheep, girl.
What?
My wife is going to kill me now. I'm laughing.
Okay.
What happened here?
You know what? You're getting the stream here, so I'm going
to
close
I just
want
to ask you, because there was one fight where I didn't want you to win. It was against Frank Bruno in 1989.
Oh, that's my man, Frank.
And he had you on the ropes.
He got me for a second. A second. That was a second. But listen.
What went through your mind then when he hesitated? Was that just like a gift?
Yeah, I was like, God damn. I said, dumbass. And I came back. Because I was on Queer Street for a tenth of a second, no doubt about that. But listen, Frank is doing great now. You know, there was news about him going into the crazy house, the Saint Asylum and stuff. And I talked to Frank, and I wanted him to know. Listen, and if that's all the guts he got, only one trip to the crazy house, I've been there 10, 20 times. And listen, if he only got a gun for one or two trips, man, he better get out of the business of life, man. Keep on going. Keep on going until you get right, Frank. That's all it is, man. Just keep going until you get right. Every now and then I think about going back, you know, but I get a grip of myself. Got these babies to take care of and shit.
You got eight children.
Yes.
Yes.
You got to
yes.
take care of these babies. That's what I get for having a lot of fun when I was young and dumb, huh? Gotta pay a lot of bills now. Gotta pay a lot of bills.
Okay, who did I miss? Did I get Joe? Did I get your question?
Yeah, a lot of stuff.
Okay, Trev, go ahead.
Big Trev.
Yeah, I was just gonna ask about your comedy acting. I mean, I think you're a phenomenal actor. I don't mean The Hangover. I mean, in particular, the Herman Cain thing that you did. I thought that was phenomenal.
Oh, Herman Cain, yeah.
Do anything other, anything like that again?
Well, man, you're a peachy bugger when you asked about that one. I'm thinking...
See? You got that accent
all
right. going.
Now, listen, I used to want to do comedy film. I want to do black film, too. I never really had the opportunity to do any kind of black film. You know, I want to do some black film and be ethnic sometime and have a ball and not get in trouble, you know, anything. So I like those kind of pictures, like, you know, the black film, like, what was this, the one we did before? I did Cookout, too, that never came out, but I just had such a good time hanging out with those guys, and it was fun. And I just like comedy. I like comedy. And whatever I do that entertains people, I'm for it.
Now-